Hello, friends. Welcome back to another episode of I Do Work Here Lady, where people who actually work at places get mistaken as regular Joe Schmoes. In this episode, there's four stories. I hope you stay for all of them and subscribe for future videos. This one's titled, I Do Work Here. Do I need to stand behind a counter to prove it to you? I just got home from work, and man, this really pissed me off. So it's a busy day for returns at the car rental company that I work for. This also means that there's many empty spaces in the parking lot because lots of people are renting cars. So I see two cars pull up, and one of them pulls into one of the spaces reserved for luxury cars for rent. It really irks me when people do this since there's a solid line indicating the return area, but they do this all the time, so I just put up with it. I go to the second car first because he stopped correctly in the return area and I was feeling spiteful. They return the car normally. I scan the barcode on the windshield, address them by their full name, and then walk around the vehicle. Then I ask for the keys and record the odometer and the fuel level. My machine prints them a receipt and they're on their way. Bear in mind that I'm in full uniform, holding a handheld scanner and printer. After I finish with them, I go over to the car parked in the wrong place and scan its barcode as I walk around the vehicle. I say, "Keith?" He says, "Yeah," warily, and giving me a suspicious look. I then ask, "Are the keys in the vehicle?" Keith says, "No, they're in my pocket." I asked if I could grab them please, and he says, "I don't give my keys to anybody," and storms off into the building to get in line at the counter. I stood there baffled as I was in full work clothes, holding a scanner and a clipboard. So I go behind the counter and plop myself at a computer, checking the returns for the day and the manifest to prove to him that I'm actually an employee. He still waits in line until my coworker has just finished renting out a car. He walks up to the counter and my coworker says, "Hi, how can I help you today?" And he mumbles, "Returning a car." Coworker looks at me and then back to him and says, "Sure, he'll be able to help you with that. He'll go get you a receipt." I run outside and check the odometer and fuel. I go back inside and shove the receipt at him, not waiting or caring whether he'd been charged the correct amount. I then turn around and go back outside. I've never been so disrespected by a customer. This one's titled, The Time My Mother Nearly Strangled a Surgeon. When I was 16, they discovered a decent-sized benign bone cyst in my right femoral neck, aka my hip. The cyst had eaten the bone, hollowing it to a dangerous degree, and I needed surgery on it. I had the bone graft done, but it was very reluctant to heal. On the fateful September afternoon, 6 weeks after surgery number one, I was going down the steps when it happened. Two steps from the bottom, I slipped, fell, and heard a sickening crunch. That lovely September day happened to be Labor Day, a major national holiday in the US. The entire process of diagnosis, finding a surgeon, etc., took nearly 12 hours. That meant, by the time we'd been transferred by ambulance to a hospital 45 minutes away for surgery, it was 2 a.m. We were told waiting until morning wasn't feasible, but don't worry, the orthopedic surgeon would be there any minute now. By this point, I was so far gone in pain that I was yelling incoherent things and attempting to claw at my neck and chest. I was also cycling through blackouts from the pain. My parents were holding me down when necessary, praying that the surgeon would arrive soon and I could be knocked out. Into this whole mess came several people, all in hospital scrubs, dropping off test results, x-rays, writing notes, giving meds, etc. It was chaos. At which point, enter a scruffy-looking man stage left. The guy was barely 5'5", looked no older than 20 years old, and was wearing a worn-out t-shirt, jeans, and dirty gym shoes. He had exactly zero identifiers on him. Without introducing himself to anyone, he grabbed the x-rays, slapped them on the light board, flicked it on, then finally turned to address my parents. The random dude said, "Let's look at these x-rays together, shall we? Mom and Dad?" Without waiting for an answer, the random dude looks at the x-rays, turns back to face my parents, and then uttered the now infamous line, "Oh, that's not good." This was the point where my stressed mother, who's been quietly panicking to herself for hours that her daughter could lose her leg, who was also stressed that it took 12 hours to reach this point, finally snapped. My mother lunged towards the random dude, only being stopped by the gurney and me in between them, and hissed at him that she'll kill him. The random guy jumped backwards and finally seemed to realize his mistake, holding his hands up and said, "Oh, sorry, I'm your daughter's new surgeon, I swear I'm supposed to be here. I'm on call and just rushed to the hospital as soon as I could, that's why I'm dressed like this." Thankfully, my mother calmed down after that, and the doctor turned out to be an amazing surgeon, and I still see him over 15 years later. But I'll never forget how my mom attempted to strangle him the first minute they met. This one's titled, "I Do Work Here, Go Wash Dishes." I managed 3 restaurants. I started as a dishwasher and worked my way up the totem pole. The owner recently retired and just pays the bills, and the rest of operations is on me. I joke around and say that the chain of command is God, the owner, me, and then there's everyone else. A year or two ago, a new shift manager had been hired, and when you run 3 restaurants, it's impossible to immediately meet every employee. I decided to pop in one day and was in one of the restaurants sitting at my favorite booth. I heard the manager dumbass talking rather loudly. He was sitting next to a server trying to take an order. I guess he was watching over her or something. Now this server has a slight learning disability but is highly functional. The new manager was standing there in front of the customers saying things like, "You have to be patient, she's slow. I'm helping improve her as much as I can." He would also berate her when she asked a customer to repeat their order since she's hard of hearing. I leaned out of the booth I was sitting in and I looked at Mary, who is the server. Now Mary's worked there for a while and she knows me quite well. She saw me and I put a finger to my lips to signal her not to say anything. Mary gave a slight nod indicating that she saw me. I got out of my booth and walked around to the kitchen. The cooks and dishwashers all said hi. I said to one of the cooks, "Tony, do me a favor and tell dumbass there's a phone call in the office for him and tell Mary that her order's up." I walked into the office, sat down, and waited. The dumb manager walked to the office and looked at me in my street clothes and said, "Look, kid, payday isn't till Monday, no advances." I responded that I'm not here for my paycheck. And he said, "Oh, you must be here for stock." "No, I'm not here for stock either," I said. "Then why are you sitting in this office and wasting my time if you don't work here?" I said to him, "Oh, I work here all right, I'm actually your boss." He then changed his tone and said, "Oh, you must be Mr. H, the head of the store, it's a pleasure to meet you." I interrupted him and said, "I heard what you're saying and seen what you're doing to Mary. You call yourself a manager, how the hell did you get this job? Mary is a sweetheart who doesn't deserve to be treated like that. She's one of the best employees and has a better attitude towards people than you ever will. I'm going to give you 3 options. 1, fire you. 2, you quit. Or 3, you take a demotion, it's your choice." DA looked at me in disbelief and said, "How do I know you work here?" I picked up the phone, called the owner, and put it on speakerphone. "Could you tell the new manager who he works for and who manages your 3 stores?" I watched as the color drained from his face. I hung up the phone and said, "Now how about those 3 options? Choose now or I'll decide for you." And he said, "I'll take the demotion." I told him good choice and to grab an apron and start doing dishes. He said, "Dishes? You're making me a dishwasher?" I told him he's no fit to lead people and if he does a good job, I'll promote him to server. I called Mary in and said, "Mary, are you okay, honey?" And that's when the dam broke. Mary broke down sobbing and said, "He does this to me all the time." I told her that I valued her and she was one of the best employees, and a slight smile came to her face as she looked at me, nodding her head yes. I told her, "All right, now go clean yourself up. Then go get your stuff and get clocked out. I'm giving you the rest of the shift off with pay." And that's when I heard the dishes crashing and her dumbass screaming, "Fuck this job, I quit." I don't know what happened to him after, and I don't care. This one's titled, "I work here, but I'm not your personal assistant." Last year, I was working the customer service desk at a mall, answering phone calls, helping customers, selling gift cards, etc. One day, I get a phone call from an older sounding woman. The woman says, "Hi, I recently bought a washing machine from you, and I need to know how it works." I responded, I'm guessing you're trying to get through to the appliance store. This is the front desk for the mall. I'll have to transfer you through to the store. The woman said, No. I don't want to be put on hold again. Can you just help? I told her that I don't know much about washing machines and that the people from the appliance store would be much more helpful. We went back and forth like this for a bit, but she really didn't want her call transferred, so I said I'd do my best to help her. It turns out, there wasn't anything wrong with the specific washing machine, she just didn't know how to use it, so I told her how to turn it on and put in the powder, etc. About 20 to 30 minutes later, I get another call from the woman. This time, she wanted me to tell her why her internet wasn't working, and she wanted me to fix it. It turns out, she just needed to restart her modem, so that was an easy fix, but still frustrating when I had an actual job to be doing. About a week goes by, and I haven't heard from her. She then shows up at the mall, looking for me. She goes up to my desk, which my manager directed her to, and hands me an envelope full of cash and says, "My power bill's due. I need you to pay it." This was the final straw for me. After telling her multiple times that I wasn't going to do that for her, and her not listening and getting very worked up, I ended up calling security on her and having her removed from the mall. I do work here, but I'm not your assistant. Hey friends, I hope you enjoyed the stories in this episode. If you didn't catch the last episode of r/IDOWorkHereLady, it's right here. If you aren't subscribed, hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss future stories. See you guys in the next one.